let us start the class. Today we are going to take revision of the syllabus that is required in the unit list. Okay, chapter 4 and chapter 5. We already know that from the chapter 4 edition, the whole chapter is required, and from chapter 5 subtraction, two topics are required, that is subtraction of 2-digit number and subtraction of 3-digit number. Okay, so let us start the revision. Before starting the revision, let us take a recap of the topics what we have got in this chapter. In this chapter, we have got addition of 2-digit numbers with regrouping. Regrouping means carryover. Addition of 3-digit number, that is without regrouping. There is no carryover. Then we have learned about properties of addition. There are three properties of addition. Then there was word problem and then framing story. So let us look at the topics and revise once again. Okay. The first I have taken here, looking at the place value chart, you already know that it is for addition. Okay, we are either going to add or subtract. The learning outcome for today is addition, so we will add the numbers here. What do you mean by addition? Addition means taking the number of objects or item together and putting together, okay, or combining them, joining them is known as addition. Okay, the mathematical sign for addition is, since we are going to add 2-digit and 3-digit number, the mathematical sign is this sign. And this sign is known as the plus sign. What it is known as? It is known as the plus sign. P-L-U-S. Plus sign. The different words used for addition are sum, total, together, in all. Okay. So these are the different words which are used in addition. And these words you can see in word problems. When you do word problems or problems based on real life, you can see words like that. Like sum, S-U-M, sum, total, T-O-T-A-L, total, together, T-O-G-E-T-H-E-R, together, and in all. In all. I-N-A-L-L. In all. So these are the words you can find when you do word problem. Okay. Based on real life situation. Now let us look at the 2-digit and 3-digit number. We already know 2-digit is with regrouping. So for with regrouping, I have kept an empty row here because we have to show what the number is transferred. And without regrouping, there is no carryover. That is why I have not shown any rows here. Alright, so let us proceed. What is the number? The number is 6 and 4. In addition as well as in subtraction, what we have learned? That always start from the 1 space. Always start from the 1 space. Okay. Now what is the number in the 1 space? 6 and 4. 6 and 4. You can add 6 and 4 mentally. Okay. You can add 6 and 4 mentally. So which is the bigger number? The bigger number is 6. You keep 6 in your mind and the next number is 4. So 6, keep 4 fingers open. So 6 is already in your mind. After 6, what will come? 7, 8, 9, 10. The answer is 10. So we know when we get a 2-digit number, we only place the digit in the 1's place and the next digit we go to the this 10's room. Okay, so 6 plus 4 we got 10, 1 will go to the 10th place. This will transfer. Okay, now what the numbers we have got? 10th place, 2 and 5 and 1 we got from this column. So I will add all the 3 numbers. Okay, so 5 plus 2, 7 plus 1, 8. So the answer is 80. Alright, now the 3-digit number. Here also from the 1's place. So 2 plus 1, 3. 2 plus 0, 2. And 1 plus 4, 5. Okay children, so this is how we do addition for 2-digit and 3-digit number. One more thing children, sometimes the place value will not be there in the exam, in the question paper. So you make the place value chart of your own using a scale and a pencil. And you always have to write 1's tens for 2-digit and 1's tens and 100 for 3-digit number. Okay. Now the next topic is properties. Properties of what? addition. Okay, so the three properties we got is here: zero property, after numbers property, and commutative property. Alright? For zero property we got, we add any number with zero, we are getting the same answer. No need to look at any example, you can see this only. 2 plus 0, we are getting 2. Okay? That means the number only we are getting what we have added with 0. So I can write any other example I can take is 17 plus 0, I will get 17. Any number you add with 0, we are getting 0. After numbers property. After numbers property is, if we add 1 with any number, we are getting the same answer. Suppose you are taking 5. What is the number after 5? The number after 5 is 6. But if you add 5 with 1, we are getting 6. Okay? Look here, one more example. You add 4 with what? 1. So 4 plus 1, we are getting 5. On the other hand, the number after 4 is also 5. So I am taking here 2 digits, here 1 digit. Example is already shown. I'll take 2 digit numbers, suppose 21. What is the number after 21? 22. So 21 I will add with 1, we are getting 22. Okay, these are examples. The third is the commutative property. Commutative property means interchanging the position of the numbers, we are getting the same answer. I'll take from here any one. Suppose 2 and 1. I'll take 2 and 1. Okay? 2 plus 1 equals to, what is the answer? 3. Same way, if I take 1 plus 2 equals to, the same answer we are getting. Okay? First, the 2 is here and 1 is second. Here 1 is first and 2 is in the second position. Okay? So this is commutative property. That means if you are changing the position, changing the order also, the answers doesn't change. Okay? So these are the three properties of addition. Next topic is framing a story sum and the word problem. Okay, framing a story sum means you will be given the numbers and out of the numbers you have to make a question out of it. Like that happens in a real life. Okay, so the number is given here is 30 plus 25 equals to 55. That means the answer is given. We have to make a question. So how will you make the question? For making the question in a story sum, we have to take the two numbers that is given, not the answer. Okay. So what is the number given here? 30 and 25. So you have to make subjects out of it. You have to place them like in examples that happens in real life. Now you can take any examples out of it. 30 and 25. So I can say that I have 30 pencil box with me. Okay, I have 30 pencil box with me. And my friend has 25 pencil box. Okay. Now since it's addition, we have to combine them in the question. So let me repeat again. I have 30 pencil box with me and my friend has 25 pencil box. Full stop. The next part will be, how many pencil do I and my friend have all together? Okay. That is one real life situation. The second question, you can take any object here. You can take pencil, you can take eraser, you can take color pencils, okay? Or you can take balls or fruits or vegetables, anything you can take, okay? So I am taking here one more example I am giving you, okay? So I will tell you, in class 1, 35 students are there. And 25 students. See, first I am taking 30. Sorry, not 35, it should be 30. And the second is 25. And 25 students in class 2. Okay? A situation is created. Now we have to make the question. So what I say here? How many students are there in both the classes? Okay, now we have to put a question. question mark after that, because we are asking a question, we are arising a question, and we don't have to do with 55 here. Sometimes in story sum the answer is given and sometimes it is not given, but for story sum we don't need the answer, we need only the first two number that is being asked to add. Okay, so what I have written in class 1, 30 students are there and 25 students in class 2. Okay, so there are two classes, class 1 and class 2. How many students are there in both the classes? This is a story sum. Okay, you can take any object, you can take any subject here. Alright, the next question is a word problem. It is an example 4 that I have taken from page number 46. So it is a 3-digit number. Let me read out the question. Mohan has 142 pencils and Shohan has 126 pencils. Okay, how many pencils do they have together, all together? So see, the word all together is used for addition. Okay, so here the statements are given here. Statements you can write on your own. So I have written in short form here. So I'll write Mohan has equals to 142 pencils. Okay, and Sohan has 126 pencils. Okay, this is known as statement. This is an introduction of what you have got in the question. Okay, now the next part of the question is how many pencils do they have all together, that is combined. Okay, so you can write total pencils equals to 142 plus 126. Okay, 142 plus 126, because the word all together is there, that means we have to combine the numbers. Now you make a place where the chart in this side. Okay, you make a place where the chart in this side with your pencil and your scale, 1s, 10s and 100. So 142 and 126. Add the numbers, so we got 8, 6 and 2. So we can say 268. So 268 pencils are there between both Mohan and Shona. Okay, so these are the topics that is given in the textbook. First is 2-digit and 3-digit numbers with and without regrouping. Then there was properties of addition, 3 properties we got. Okay, and then we got story sum, where we have to create a word problem, where we have to ask question based on real life. And word problems are given, we have to find a solution. Okay children, so these are the topics in the chapter 4 edition. In the next class we will be revising about the next chapter, that is subtraction. Okay, so thank you, have a nice day.